biryani is, if you actually take the literal term of biryani, which was out from outside India, how it entered in India was when the Mughals were invading India almost 1,000 years ago. At that time, the biryani came into India, but that is not how the Indians used to like the way eating the rice. So they used to eat the rice the pulao way, I would say that. But Mughals, they brought biryani to India because when the Aurangzeb or the team used to travel while invading India, their soldiers used to have biryanis, and at that time, that's how the biryanis entered through Mughals into India. But the entire concept got changed when there was a fusion between the Indian traditional way of doing Indian biryanis, which was earlier called as pulao. Mumtaz Mahal actually captured that particular, created a fusion out of that for Shah Jahan, which was, I must talk about it, that she used to do, she knows how the Mughals used to do the biryanis, and then she learned how the Indians used to do their pulaos. She created a marriage between the two, and that fusion actually turned out to be the Indian version of the biryanis what we are having today. However, my wife, she still wanted to follow the same style of the way the Indians used to do pulao, which was a layered form of doing biryanis, or pulao, I would say, and applying dum to it. That was from the era of Chanakya or the Avadh, I would say, or the Chandragupt Maurya or the Ashoka's times. I'm talking about that is the time she followed. Now, how I came into this, because of the concept which you're asking, she was the first lady who started commercially doing 5 vegetarian biryanis and 10 non-vegetarian biryanis right from day one. And all are so flavorful that we do, our highest selling biryanis are vegetarian biryanis. It's not that I'm not saying that our non-vegetarian biryanis are not highest selling. Yes, they are highest selling, of course, but ultimately the jackfruit biryani, the cuttle biryani, steals the entire show. And we do the maximum 2,000 kilos every month, only the jackfruit biryani for Delhi. The deep discounting and all these things are hurting much, of course. Right. But at the same time, they are hurting to an extent how much you are able to, not able to manage the show effectively. Because deep discounting is a strategy which the online platforms are following.
Right.
Because the industry is booming and there are more restaurants than what is expected and what is required to be, because of the online platforms, a single cloud kitchen is actually doing more many number of restaurants to, and hence online platforms are forced to give deep discounting. That is the reason why the deep discounting is hurting the people. But if you're able to, if you know the tricks how to manage and how to steal in between, I think instead of deep discounting, you should more worried about the cost of the product. Because the deep discounting, restaurants are also smart enough in today's times that they are able to increase the pricing, and there is no, I would say, law on that.
Right.
And because of that, we are able to play with any kind of a pricing for the consumers. The product which used to cost, just imagine, the product which used to cost us at 50% of the price when we used to go and eat at the restaurant, today it costs us at least 200 times to just make up those margins.
Right.
So the restaurants and the brands who knows, even if there is a deep discounting, they have a clear marketing strategy, they know how to play around with, they just increase their pricing, and it's an easy game altogether, because the customer only looks at, while ordering, they only looks at that how much discount they are getting. They don't even understand that at what price they are buying the product and what price they were buying it earlier. 70% is online.
Oh, okay.
The reason why 70% is online, because we are doing the QSR way. Right. When you do the QSR way, your focus is not on the dine-in.
Right.
Your focus is purely on the delivery or on, I would say, the online platforms. Yeah. For the reason that when we talk about biryanis, you would love to have biryanis with your friends, with your families, and when you want to throw a party, of course. Nobody has biryanis solely. Very rare the people will go and ask for a biryani which is going to be like, okay, only I want to eat it.
Yeah.
So biryani is one of the most premium product of India.
Mm.
That's how the biryanis are being treated in India.
Mm.
Expansion plans are fantastic right now. That's when I said that we are the fastest emerging brands in India.
Yeah.
We have already established from in Ladakh.
Mm.
We are about to open up an outlet in Bangalore. Mm. We are already there in Delhi NCR. We are entering Rajasthan and Andhra Pradesh again next month. On the other hand, we have an aggressive franchising plans, which we expect to be reaching the 100 number within the next 2 years. And we also, we are open for the international market as well, wherein we have started our first outlet in Melbourne. But nonetheless, we have inquiries from Canada, from US, from London. We have already started getting the inquiries.